Hey, Measuring Hero, Jay here. Today we are back at one of the material research labs in Aalen University to kind of keep going down our journey on analyzing batteries. So Andreas has been kind enough to welcome us back. Andreas, thank you for having us back.
Appreciate You're welcome. It.
Okay, I'm pretty pumped because you told us last time we were going to cut open a battery to analyze it. I'm pretty pumped to do it. What are we looking at here?
Yes, if we want to open the battery, we cannot do it under a normal atmosphere, so we have to go inside the glove box to avoid any damages because of the oxygen.
Okay, what would happen if we didn't cut that open in one of these boxes?
There can be unwanted side reactions inside the material, and also the electrolyte is poison.
Okay, so it would not be good for us and maybe explode?
If we are not careful enough, it will explode. Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's make sure we don't do that. So what are we doing here?
So there we open the battery cells and get out the electrolyte. We also do a washing to get out the electrolyte inside the pores. And so after that, we can proceed with the further preparation of the cell.
Okay. And there's a lot of different equipment. What equipment are you... you typically need to do this type of work?
Yes, it depends always on the investigation we want to do. So there's also a microscope inside the glove box to avoid any interference of the side reactions. Or we do some cell testing in here to test the electrodes.
Okay, so what kind of atmosphere or pressure is being accomplished there? In these boxes?
Pressure is slightly higher than the atmosphere to prevent any oxygen in getting inside the chamber.
Okay, so there's no oxygen in that chamber whatsoever?
No.
Is there any special, is it just off-the-shelf equipment that can survive in there, or do you have to do?
Sure, the equipment has to handle the non-oxygen atmosphere, but it's normal equipment.
Is that an off-shelf size microscope that we put in there, or is that a special one?
There are special adjustments made, but it's more or less off-shelf. Yeah.
Pretty off-the-shelf. Yeah. Cool. All right, so what is the process of preparing a battery for analysis in here?
So we have to open the cell and have to make sure that the electrolyte is getting outside, so we wash them. And we do it inside the chamber to prevent any oxygen reactions with the battery material inside.
So we actually cut it and we wash it and then maybe do a little bit of analysis in there?
Depends on what we are looking. So we can use the microscope already in there to look, have a first look on the battery, or we have to do a further preparation in the microscopy lab.
Further preparation, can we see that?
Sure.
All right, let's go have a look.
Yeah.
Okay, so I understand that there's more preparation that's involved in making these samples. So what are we going to do next?
Next, we have to put the battery piece or the battery sample and pour it into some epoxy resin to get it or to fix it and fixate the microstructure from breaking out. Then we put the sample into one of these sample holders, and this one rotates over a grinding paper, and then we are becoming a much more smooth surface and a polished surface.
So we'll go from different grits to different grits and then get it?
Yeah, we are always using finer paper or finer grinding suspensions with diamonds in it.
Got it. Okay, so we take the battery sample, we cut it like we did over there, put it in resin, and then just grind it so we get a really, really smooth place to take an image, right?
Exactly, yes.
Awesome. Then after that, what do we do?
After that, we can go to the microscope and have a closer look on the microstructure.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay,
this looks like a pretty intense setup.
It is, actually.
what is this? What are we looking at?
Yeah, this is a microscope with a quite big table so that we can have a look at really great images and great samples. So now we take our battery sample into our sample holder.
All right.
And then we can go under the microscope and have a close look on the microstructure.
Okay.
So here we can see like single particles within the electrode coatings.
Oh, wow.
And then we have a closer look for any defects or faults or particles that shouldn't be in there.
Sure.
And try to analyze them.
Sure, sure. So yeah, after all of that process, we're now really able to get in there and see what we're supposed to see. Now is where the art comes in to try to figure out what's supposed to be there versus what isn't supposed to be there, and then to try to cause back to something that might cause a defect or...
Exactly. So if we take one image of a battery, it's about 50 gigabytes gig.
Oh, jeez, okay.
So we need some help to analyze it. So there we are using machine learning algorithms that help us to automatically detect defects within the microstructure. And then we can try to figure out where does those defects come from and what is their influence on the quality and the performance.
Does it cause performance on the battery, good or bad, right?
Good or bad, or is it a secure or safety issue? Mm-hmm. Will the battery explode because of that failure, or is it just losing performance?
That's really important to know. We really don't want a battery to explode on us,
do we? Not really.
Cool. All right, so what I'm seeing here is we, after this process of actually taking the battery and cutting it, and then really, really taking a lot of time to prepare the sample, we look under a microscope to really see and understand. And after a while of doing this, we use learning algorithms to actually help us figure out what is good and bad.
Yes, and to handle the large amount of image data we are producing, because it's too much for a single person to look through all those images.
Right, so that definitely speeds up throughput.
Yes.
Andreas, what an amazing process and the work that you guys do here in Aalen University. It's been an honor for you to show me around and just have a really brief glimpse at what you do here for battery research. Thank you so much for your time.
You're welcome.
All right, appreciate it. And with you, thank you for joining us again, going on this really, really super nerdy journey about batteries, but we hope you continue to stay safe and stay healthy, and we'll see you next Thursday.